So welcome to today's news reads related to artificial intelligence. This is published on the Vox.com. Why Elon Musk fears artificial intelligence. And it's kind of an old article, but I have included it because of the obvious facts that it kind of highlights about the unchecked growth of artificial intelligence. So speaking at MIT, Elon Musk has already reiterated again and again that AI is humanity's biggest existential threat, and he kind of compared it to summoning the demon. So as AI gets probably much smarter than the humans, the relative intelligence ratio is probably similar to that between a person and a cat, and maybe bigger. So this comparison is very much practical. The biggest problem issue with all this skepticism or all this doubt arises from the fact that our definition of intelligence is highly relative. We do not define intelligence. All these algorithms which are being used, like in deep learning and all this extension of reinforcement learning and multi-agent learning, we do not have a very insightful definition of intelligence. It's relative in a sense that we have assumed that it on the basis of neurobiological understanding of neurons, but there are a lot of loopholes, there are a lot of gaps in the understanding of the intelligence. Is intelligence is like an ontological concept, or is it like as mentioned in the Computing Machinery and Intelligence by the Alan Turing, like this is a step-by-step process in which we can achieve the full intelligence by creating some procedural methods. So in this sense that there are different perspectives, but two major perspectives are that one, who people who are really skeptical of the AI superintelligence, and others are embracing it, like from the big technical behemoths like Facebook, Google, and other high-end investors. They are really positive about the AI advancements. Yeah, it's kind of comes natural, like they have a lot of investment there. But on the contrary, a lot of influential like Elon Musk and Nick Bostrom and even Stephen Hawking, he also have mentioned like we have to be very careful about this, the progressing capability of these futuristic technologies, the artificial intelligence, when it reaches to the singularity. The takeaway is very clear. Okay, we have to do more research. We need to be very careful with all these regulations. So he has been trying for the past 1 year or two to force the US committees for the more regulations on AI. Like there was a Congress committee with which he met, Elon Musk met, and already they tried to create awareness in the US Congress and other leaders of the world, but all was futile. All of this effort is like did not made the impact which was expected. But have a government committee that starts off with insight, gaining insights, spends a year or two gaining insights about AI or other technology that may be dangerous, but especially AI, and then based on that insights comes up with the rules and consultation with the industry that gives the highest probability for a safe advent of AI. And the main reason is that the concentration of power that is happening in the Google and Facebook and all these big technological company like in China, Alibaba, the Baidu, and they have a lot amount of data, and they are practically the czars of these futuristic technology. And so for that, to check that power, he created OpenAI, Elon Musk, and REST, we all know like how exactly it's going, and it is making a great advancement. But the essential idea is that why he's so skeptical and why he's raising the alarm, because people at Google and who have developed AlphaGo and AlphaZero, there are two aspects to this: people who are actually developing it and others are investors. So the as a whole, the people are not that much worrisome. They should be, but there's no accountability among the developers and the creators of these super futuristic algorithms. So just like MIT professor has said that, okay, just like the nuclear weapon, we are not learning from our mistakes. We create some technology, something, we invent something. Like with the cars, we have created cars, and because of the unsafe accidents, we ended up creating seat belts or better traffic regulations. And as a result, these things got controlled. But like the nuclear weapons, it's like opening a Pandora's box. And just like that, AI is it's going to be the same thing. And once, like Nick Bostrom, he shares this skepticism at Oxford that once unfriendly superintelligence exists, it would prevent us from replacing it or changing its preference, or our fate will be sealed. Once it reaches a minimum threshold of intelligence, whatever it may be, it will always be relative. Then it will be very difficult to put it back in the final nail in the coffin. We are done. The superintelligence or this extremely connected, scaled up systems will rule, just like in Terminator or in different sci-fi movies. And the Y Combinator's hits a startup, Sam Altman of Y Combinator said that in next few decades, we are either going to head towards self-destruction or towards human descendants eventually colonizing the universe. So these are the things that were put there. And rightly so, the ultimate takeaway is, the takeaway from this article is that we must understand and know what we are working on when it comes to artificial intelligence and its related technologies. And regulations are really important, and the democratization of the data and artificial intelligence is again very important. So these are the main majority points that needs to be kept in mind, which is no one is doing right now, but these are the most important things which are supposed to be taken care of. So this was an old article. It was there, but I felt it should be shared. And tomorrow it will be a very different, or it will be something that is I will bring something more interesting. And put your questions down below, and we can have a discussion on that. And consider joining this channel. Thank you.